Okay, now phasor diagram, detailed analysis of phasor diagram, detailed analysis of phasor diagram for silent pole synchronous machine. Okay, because already we have seen the phasor diagram for non-silent pole synchronous machine, lagging power factor, load, leading power factor, like from this thing we have find this equation E naught equal to root of V phase cos phi, all those things. These are all for non-silent pole alternator. This is for silent pole alternator. We have to analyze this phasor diagram. From the phasor diagram only we can find the value of E naught. Here, what are the quantities are known quantity means, one is IA, armature current is known quantity, that we can measure. Then V phase, that is rated voltage phase value, this is known quantity, and phi, cos phi is known quantity, so that phi is known quantity. Okay, what are the unknown quantities means, this ID, direct axis current, quadraxis axis current, and what is the other value, delta, then psi, these are the unknown quantities. These are the things we have to find. After finding this thing, we have to find E naught. If we find E naught, that is regulation, we can find E naught minus V naught. Okay, what is the first thing? First thing I am drawing this x axis and this is y axis. Okay, first I have to draw the current. Which current? IA current. IA consists of two components. What are the things? IA consists of ID plus IQ. IQ, it will be in which axis? E naught. I am taking this as an E naught. This will be along with E naught, but the magnitude will be very small. So this is equal to what is the value? This is equal to IQ, magnitude of IQ. But we don't know the value of magnitude, just I am drawing. After that only we can find this value. This is equal to ID. ID will be perpendicular to E naught. ID will be perpendicular to E naught and IQ will be along with E naught. I am taking X axis as an E naught. Right, okay. So what the addition? The addition of IQ plus ID. Both the things if I add, I will get IA. This is only known quantity. IA. This is IA. Okay. For lagging power factor, if I take lagging power factor, current will lag. So that voltage will lead. So this is the lagging. This is nothing but what is this? This is V phase. Okay. What is the angle between E naught and V naught? The angle between E naught and V naught is called delta, power angle. And the angle between E naught and IA, that E naught and IA is called psi. The angle between this is called psi. That angle between voltage and current is called phi. You have to know the difference between all those things. The angle between real voltage and real current is called, that current is called phi, and angle between no load voltage and rated voltage is called delta, and no load voltage and current, armature current is called psi. Okay, these are the things we have to know. Okay, then along with this thing, what I had to add IARA. Actually, IARA also I can divide into two parts. What is thing? IARA also I can write IA. This IA can be divided into two parts. One is ID into RA plus IQ into RQ by adding the two things. So what is the thing? ID into RA will be in this direction. ID into RA will be in this direction and IQ into RQ will be in this IQ direction. This is IQ direction. If I add this thing, it will be in this direction, IA direction. This is IA into RA. See, IA and I, this is IARA. This is IARA. This IARA and IA will be both in the same direction. How we are drawing? Again, IARA, I am dividing into two components, ID into RA, IQ into RA. This will be ID into RA. This is IQ into RA. This is ID into RA. By adding these two things, I am getting this thing. If I get this thing, this will be in parallel. Not parallel. This IA line and this IARA will be in parallel. Next, what I had to add? I had a ID into XQ. ID into XD. ID into XD will be 90 degree leading ID. This is ID into XD. This will be 90 degree leading. Leading means this direction. Similarly, IQ into XQ will be leading IQ by an angle 90 degree. So this direction. So this is IQ into XQ. So what is this value? This full value is called, this is E naught. Here I am putting F. This O, this is origin. OF is our required. What is the value? Required. E naught value. Okay, so I am out to find means I am putting like dotted line like this thing. I am putting a dotted line like this thing. This is A dash, this is H dash. So what is E naught? E naught equal to O H dash plus H dash A dash plus A dash F. If I add all those things, I will get all those things. Okay, what is OH dash? If we are trying this V face triangle, what is the angle? The angle is called V face. The angle between V face is called delta. The angle between V face and E naught. E naught is called delta. V face and E naught. This is called delta. So what is the sine delta? So what is OH? OH equal to what is the value? OH equal to what delta? V face into cos delta. Because cos delta is equal to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Adjacent side this is, therefore OH equal to V face cos delta plus H dash A dash. What is H dash A dash? It is IQ into RA plus IQ into RA plus what is this value? A dash F. A dash equal to ID into XD. ID into XD. So if I add this thing, I will get the value of E naught. But the thing is that we do not know the value of delta. We have to find the value of delta. How to find the value of delta? So we have to go for some derivation for this thing. Okay. What is the derivation? Okay. The first thing is that ID equal to ID. What is ID? But this is ID. This ID means this is also ID. Okay, what is ID? ID equal to what is the value? What is the angle between that thing? The angle is IA and E naught. The angle is psi. The angle here, this angle is psi. Okay, this angle is psi. Okay, this angle is psi. So I am taking this triangle, small triangle. This angle is psi. So which is ID equal to this hypotenuse. Hypotenuse into this is opposite side. Yes, this is opposite side. So it is sine psi because the angle between E naught and IA is psi. So I am taking this triangle OIA, this IQ, this triangle I am taking. In this, if I take this triangle, sine alpha equal sine psi equal to this is psi. Sine psi equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Therefore, ID equal to similarly IQ equal to IA into cos psi. So for this, what is cos psi? Cos psi equal to IQ divided by IA. This we have to know. These are all not known quantities. Psi is not known quantity. IQ, IA are all not known quantity because we have to find this all this quantity. With the known quantities are only IA, V phase, phi. And XD, XQ we can find by using slip test. XD and XQ. We can use the slip test and we can find XD and SQ. Next session we will find the how to use slip test to find XD and XQ. Okay, this is cos psi. Okay, after finding cos psi, so okay. Now what is the thing we have to find the cos psi? What is the thing I had to find? I had to find the value of psi. How to find the value of psi? Okay, that we are having the formula. Okay, before that thing, I am drawing a line perpendicular to this IARA. This is IARA. Perpendicular to IARA. Perpendicular to IARA. Perpendicular to IA. Both are same. I am drawing a line perpendicular to IARA. Okay, like this thing. That is, the meaning is that this angle is 90 degree. This will meet this point C. This will meet this point. 1 minute, I will take this thing. Okay, this will meet the point C. That is, I am drawing a line perpendicular to IARA. That automatically this will be perpendicular. This will be also in perpendicular because both are parallel line only. So here also it will be perpendicular. This will meet C. Here I am drawing a perpendicular line. Here again I am drawing a perpendicular line. Okay, this is called B. This is called B and this is called E. E is already known quantity and this point I am taking as an A and this point as H. This is AH, this is A dash H dash. Already we know the point and this is V face is G point. There will be many things are there. It's very difficult to see all those things. I will explain. Okay, although I will explain all those things. Okay, here. What the main thing is that here this angle is, what is the angle? This angle is psi. This angle, that is angle between E naught and IA. Similarly, I can prove this angle is psi. How means? We know that if there are two lines are there, if this angle and this angle are equal, okay, similarly like this and this angle are equal like this. If I go like this thing, I can prove that this angle equal to psi. we can easily prove this. And see, I had to go for a neat diagram for this thing. So since I'm not having neat diagram, I cannot prove that this angle is, but this angle is psi. Okay, by this formula only. Okay, this angle is psi. So now I'm taking the triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, ABC, cos I equal to, what is cos I? Adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. What is adjacent side? Adjacent side equal to BC. What is hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is AC. What is BC value? BC will be equal to IQ into XQ, which is equal to IQ into XQ divided by AC, which is equal to cos I. What is the value of cos I? Already we know cos I equal to IQ divided by IA, which is equal to IQ divided by IA. This thing already we know the thing. So I am cancelling IQ and IQ, I am cancelling. From this thing what I am getting? AC equal to IA into XQ. That is AC. This AC equal to IA into XQ. This AC equal to, but this value already known, IQ into XQ, and this value also known quantity. This AE is known quantity. So AC equal to IA into XQ. This value we are. Then what we are finding from this thing, AC equal to IA into XQ. Okay. Then we are finding tan psi. What is tan psi? Tan psi equal to, what is tan psi here? In this thing, what is tan psi? Tan psi equal to AB divided by tan psi equal to CD by OD, CD, O, if it's okay, tan psi, I'm going for this triangle, that is OC and this triangle, greater triangle, this is perpendicular, okay, I'm going for this big triangle, OC, this big triangle, the angle is, here the angle is delta, here we don't know the angle, here the angle is perpendicular, this is perpendicular, because already we have drawn this line, perpendicular to IARA, which is also perpendicular to IA, because perpendicular, this large triangle I am taking, where tan psi equal to, what is the value equal to, CD, this is D, this point is D. That is, which is perpendicular, this is perpendicular line, CD equal to adjacent side divided by, what is sine phi divided by cos psi, what is the thing, it is equal to CD by OD. CD means, see, this is perpendicular, but what is perpendicular, what is opposite side, this is opposite side, so OC, it is not CD, CD divided by OD, okay, CD, opposite, because this is psi, okay, psi opposite side, this is opposite side, this is CD, where CD is there, this is CD is the opposite side, and OD, this is O, okay, which is O, this is hypotenuse, why it is hypotenuse, this is right angle, if this is right angle, this is hypotenuse won't come for tan psi, because tan psi equal to sine psi divided by cos psi, opposite side divided by adjacent side, opposite side is nothing but psi is here, opposite side equal to CD, and adjacent side equal to OD, adjacent side equal to OD, so this thing, CD plus OD, okay, just I will remove all those things, okay, I will have only this AC value, okay, AC value already we have written, no issue, okay, what is tan psi, okay, what is the value of CD, otherwise OD equal to OD, which is OD, this is OD, okay, I can draw a perpendicular line from here, okay, here I have a triangle, in this triangle, this is the triangle, mean this is hypotenuse, this is hypotenuse, okay, that value equal to OD equal to OI, OD equal to OI, plus ID, here I am putting as this is a I, this is OD equal to OI plus ID, what is OI, this angle is called, what is the thing, then this phi, okay, this is hypotenuse, this OG is hypotenuse, so this is adjacent side, okay, what is adjacent side equal to V face sin phi, yeah, V face sin phi, OI equal to V face cos adjacent side means we will get cos phi, so which is equal to V face cos phi plus what is this value? This value will be equal to this value. This value is IERA, already we know that value. This is already we had an IERA, so this value also IERA plus IARA. This is OD. OD equal to C. OD equal to OI plus ID. OI, I am drawing a perpendicular line, this thing. So this is a triangle. This angle is phi. This angle is phi. This is this angle is right angle. So this is hypotenuse, opposite side. So this is opposite side. This is adjacent side. This is hypotenuse. So adjacent side is V face, because this line is V face. So this is V face cos phi. Okay, plus this line IA into RA. This IARA and both IARA same. Similarly, what is CD? CD equal to AD plus CD equal to AD plus AC. AC. What is AC? AC already we have find. AC equal to IA into XQ. Already we have found this thing. Okay. Now I remove this thing. Okay. What is AD? What is this AD? This AD value is nothing but same triangle. It's the same this triangle. This value. That is AD and GA are same value. Because this is a parallel. Both are same line. This is V face. Okay, V face, okay, and sin phi, because opposite side, V face sin phi. This is V face cos phi, this is V face sin phi. So V face sin phi. Okay, plus sound. So what is automatically, what is tan psi? Automatically tan psi equal to, what is the value already we have seen? Tan psi equal to CD by OD. Already we have found CD. CD equal to what the value? CD equal to V face sin phi plus IA into XQ divided by V face cos phi plus IA into RA. From this thing, this is tan psi. From this value, tan psi, we can find the value of psi. Tan inverse, we can. Here, V phase is known quantity. Sin phi, power factor is known quantity. From this, we can say IA value is also known quantity. XQ, XD value, we are going to find by using whichever slip test. Slip test, we are going to use and find. And here, the delta value is for delta, we had to find, because this is the formula we had to find. This is the required thing. V phase cos delta plus IQ into RA plus ID into, from delta equal to what is the value? From psi, what you are finding? Delta. Delta equal to psi minus phi for lagging power factor. And delta equal to psi plus phi for leading power factor. Okay, so if we find the value of psi, after that psi, once if a value of psi is found, phi is known quantity, because it is cos phi is good, power factor is known quantity, phi we can find. So delta equal to psi minus phi for lagging power factor, delta equal to psi plus phi for leading power factor. So these two quantities we can find. Once we know two quantities can find, we can substitute here V phase cos phi, IRA, we can know all the quantities. This E naught is known quantity, E naught we can find. Once we find the E naught value, we can find the value of this thing, regulation, E naught minus V phase. This is for generator. Okay, so this is for generator. For motor, nothing but this E naught will come inside, V phase will go inside. Otherwise I can write like this thing. I will remove all those things. See, this is E naught. Okay, there, if for motor, this is for generator, alternator. Okay, for motor, V E naught equal to V phase cos phi, sorry, cos delta minus IQ into RA minus ID into XD. This is for motor. Okay, this is for alternator, generator or alternator. Okay, so first what we are going to find, we are finding the value of psi, we are finding, from psi we are finding the value of delta, then we are substituting E naught. This is for this E naught value. Once we find the E naught value, we can find the regulation. So this is the method. Okay,